It's not hard to find the naysayers out there. There'll be a whole variety of people all over the universe that'll tell you why Alberta shouldn't be a $30 billion industry in the agribusiness and the value-added business. But that reminds me a little of my Royal York octogenarian. In Toronto, I was invited by the government of Canada to be on a panel dealing with women in the workplace. And they chose 6 men to serve on the panel. In its infinite wisdom, what better choice? But the MC was a woman sitting in the back of the room, gauging us. As we introduced her, she got up to walk towards the platform. As she walked onto the platform, her heels caught in her gown. And for a minute, she teetered, and then she fell forward. We didn't want to rush forward from our chairs to help her because we knew she was already embarrassed. The sheen was on her forehead, the red was in her face, and we could see that her motions were jittery. She walked up to the mic, and she did what so many of us do when we are not in control. She pounded on it to see if it was on, and it was on full force, and it went ba-bom, ba-bom. Now everybody was looking at her. Now what do you do? Two faux pas, you haven't even started. So she started backing up to get away from the audience, whose eyes were riveted on her. As she stepped to the back, her heels caught at the end of the platform. You didn't know that the platform didn't go out to the end of the wall because the curtain was at the edge of the platform. Like a great American eagle, the curtains parted and she soared off into the background. Now the audience roared, just like you are laughing, because it is funny. The plain truth is, as sympathetic and compassionate as we all are, that's horrendous. And it is also entertaining, but don't let it happen to your grandparent. In any case, the 6 of us now decided we shouldn't just sit there catapulted into immobility. We should do something. So we rushed backwards like penguins, parted the curtain, and she appeared. We canceled the event. People were laughing. Others were leaving. They thought it was ridiculous. And a couple of months later, I was sitting at another seminar at the Sheraton this time. There was an empty seat to my right, and suddenly I felt the commotion. I looked to my right, and there was my lady. I looked up at her, and she grinned down at me, and she said, "Hi, do you remember me?" I said, "My God, ma'am, the whole Western world remembers you." "Could I ask you a question?" I said. And I'd like to conclude on this. Could I ask you a question? How could you come back from all that? You heard the laughter in the audience. You heard the naysayers. You know the cynics were there. You know some of them will be in your audience here today. And she said, "Stop. I've got 2 vital principles for you to remember if you're going to face the challenge of the leader. Don't look back. Look ahead. The truth of the matter is most of us spend the whole energy base that we have trying to assess where we went wrong in the past, in training, in trading, in business. Don't look back because that's counterproductive. Look ahead." And the second thing she said is, don't listen to the braying of the jackals. Listen to the pounding of your own soul. Well, I can't tell you what your soul tells you, but I know what my soul tells me. I'm one lucky devil to be a Canadian.